everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. Now, in this video, we're going to unbox, install and review the Hoyer Brockhaus mechanical vise. This mechanical vise is a vise of 160 mm width of the clamps. I will also install the rotary table that can be ordered together with it. So you can see that Hoyer is sending it with the handle sticking out, which is an interesting way to save some space in the boxing. As you can see, I took the one with the replaceable jaw elements. I did that because when they're going to be damaged somehow by grinding, plasma cutting or whatever, of course I'm not intending to, but you never know, then I can always replace them. Now what I like about it is that it's completely made out of forged steel, and Hoyer Brockhaus is claiming that it's unbreakable. Now I don't think I will try that out. There are some other videos on YouTube where they're really trying to break vices. I'm not going to do that with this one. But I'm very sure it's an extremely strong vise. What I also really like about the Hoyer vises is that with this bolt you can remove all the play in the vise. So that makes sure that you will never have any play. You can easily twist the bolt a little and it's gone. The same bolt you can also use to take apart the vise and do some service on the bearing system, which of course will not be needed because it's brand new. But that's also very interesting, you can do that very easily by just removing the single bolt. Here we see the rotating table. Let's also have a look. Same hook, I expect. Here you see the rotating table of Hoyer. It's an original part that can be mounted on, which makes it very easy to rotate. My current vise has always been fixed, and with this rotating table it increases the flexibility of the vise, which makes it even more interesting. Another thing that I ordered with the vise are these protective jaws. Now they come with a magnetic clip, as you can see over here, which makes them stick to the vise. We'll look at that later. So the first thing we now need to do is to take off the old vise. So now all the bolts are removed. I can now take off the vise. It will not be thrown away. I will have a look at it, replace the bolt over here, reduce some of the play, and I'm going to reuse it in a welding table, which is another project, and I will show that in a later video. Now the top part of this workbench is wood, which I like to work on, but there is a steel construction underneath that is connected to the remaining part of the frame. The previous vise was also connected towards this steel frame, which makes it much more rigid, much more strong. Now the same I want with the new vise. Now the rotating table has three holes to connect it to, so I will make sure that those three holes will be properly connected to the steel framework below. This is the bottom view of the workbench, and here you can see the bolt that's coming through, the bolt that is going to connect towards the rotating table. And in order to have a rigid connection towards the metal frame of the workbench, I will put in an angle profile like this. So let's put it in the same color as the workbench. This is hammerite, so no problem to put it over the corroded material. So I will use this 12mm bolt together with a specially made bracket in order to have a proper connection of the vise to the workbench. So of course in most of the cases it will use perpendicular towards the workbench, but if for some reason it's better to give it another angle, it's quite easy to do it with the revolving table, and it's quite simple to block it with the pen. So this is about the maximum opening of the Heuer vise, which is 225mm, which is according to the specification. The dimension of the rotation table is such that it is possible to mount a vertical beam inside the vise. Here you see the pipe jaws, which are also a very interesting feature. Now the original protective jaws can be mounted very easily because they have a magnet. So they are very simple to mount. They stick well. Now this is the type G protective jaw, which is made of rubber. It's for clamping of thin walled tubes and shaped pieces, wood and plastic parts. And these are the fiber protective jaws. Which are made for clamping of work pieces with finely machined or polished faces. It also stated that there's no deformation of the faces even when clamping warm work pieces. When you for example do some flame soldering or other heat type of processes, and you want to prevent the heat getting into your vise, because that might affect your hardening properties of your material. And also there, these protective jaws are very good for. And this is a protective jaw made of aluminium that can be used for clamping of material of various shapes. For example, round or oval pieces. And this cutout is specially made for horizontal clamping of flat materials. Like this. And this is a general aluminium protective jaw for clamping of rough to medium machined work pieces. Now of course the aluminium is much softer than the steel of the standard material of the jaw, and as a result it will not damage the work piece because of the softer aluminium. What you clearly notice is the lack of play in this vise. But this is the Hoyer Vice, a German quality tool, very robust, very strong, forged steel. So they state it's unbreakable. Well, I'm not going to try it out, but I'm very sure it's a very strong vice. Because of the bearing, it's as good as no play on it. The slider has this special bearing, which also is very easy to remove all the play once you've used it for some time. Of course, the revolving table makes it easy to put it at different angles, which is also a nice thing. And last but not least, the protective jaws I really like a lot. I think I will frequently use them, especially the rubber and the one with the special shapes for connecting small access tubes, things like that. Now I'm looking forward to work with this vice in all the work on the oncoming projects. I like the quality and I also like the possibility to have the replaceable jaws, especially when you want to do some fine work with it. Now I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. See you next time.